Taking question number 16 of miscellaneous exercise of chapter 2, inverse trigonometric functions. The question is, we have been given an equation and from this equation we have to calculate the value of x and we have to tell which of the option is correct. Okay, now to solve this objective question, first of all I take the equation. Sine inverse of 1 minus x minus 2 sine inverse of x is equal to pi by 2. Okay. So first thing what I'm going to do to simplify this, I'm going to take sine inverse of 1 minus x to the right hand side. So the equation would be like this. Now this pi by 2 minus sine inverse of 1 minus x can be written as cos inverse of 1 minus x. So this will be equal to 2 sine inverse of x is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus x. Okay. Further, this sine inverse of x is written as cos inverse of square root of 1 minus x square. Simply I have written the value of sine inverse x in terms of cos inverse x. Okay, so this has been done in previous questions, so I am not explaining here. Okay, now to solve further, we place x as equal to sine y. Okay, so on placing x is equal to sine y, I am going to get the left hand side as minus 2 cos inverse of square root of 1 minus sine square y is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus sine y. Okay. So this square root of 1 minus sine square y can be written as cos y. So on the left hand side I get minus 2 times cos inverse of cos y. So this term will become y. Okay. So I get here minus 2y is equal to cos inverse of 1 minus sine y. Taking cos of both sides, I can get cos of minus 2y is equal to 1 minus sine y. I know that cos of minus theta is equal to cos theta. So this can be written as cos 2y is equal to 1 minus sine y. Okay. Further, cos 2y can be written as 1 minus 2 sine square y, left right hand side as it is. This 1 and 1 is cancelled, so I obtained minus 2 sine square y is equal to minus sine y, or 2 sine square y is equal to sine y. Taking sine y to the left hand side and factorizing, I get sine y into 2 sine y minus 1 is equal to 0. So this gives me sine y is equal to 0, or 2 sine y minus 1 is equal to 0. So because sine y was assumed by me as equal to x, that is I have substituted sine y as equal to x, so I get sine y is equal to 0, or x is equal to 0, or 2x minus 1 is equal to 0. So this gives me x is equal to 1 by 2. So the possible answer for this equation is x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 1 by 2. But x is equal to 0 clearly satisfies this equation, because we can see that in left hand side if I place x is equal to 0, so I get sine inverse of 1 minus 0 minus 2 sine inverse of 0. So this gives me sine inverse of 1, because sine inverse of 0 is 0, so this whole term will become 0 and this will be equal to right hand side. Okay, so x is equal to 0 is a definite solution of this equation. Okay, now if I take x is equal to 1 by 2, then placing x is equal to 1 by 2 in the left hand side, I get sine inverse of 1 minus 1 by 2 minus 2 sine inverse of 1 by 2. This is going to become 1 by 2. So this can be further written as sine inverse of 1 by 2 minus 2 sine inverse of 1 by 2, or minus sine inverse of 1 by 2. Sine inverse of 1 by 2 is pi by 6, so this value become minus pi by 6, and this is unequal to right hand side. Okay, so left hand side is unequal to right hand side, so this shows that x is equal to 1 by 2 is not a possible solution. Therefore, the correct option is C, because x is equal to 0 is the only solution of this equation. Friends, thanks for watching my video. To watch more of these super videos and for the latest updates, subscribe and like the videos on these channels on YouTube, HSK Shiksha and Math Help by HSK.
Thank you.